Good morning, dear student. I am Dr. Sachin R. Gengze, professor and head of Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur. We will continue with our session on electronic commerce. In the last lecture or last session, we had a brief introduction to electronic commerce, and we'll continue with that in this session. The learning outcome of this session include: after watching this video, you student will able to explain e-commerce framework, and then you can differentiate between e-commerce and e-business on a larger scale. We'll just repeat a fundamental definition of e-commerce. So what is e-commerce? E-commerce is a process of buying, selling, transferring, serving, or exchanging product, services, or information via computer network, which can include internet also, and using computer or digital devices like smartphone as the end devices. So the basic of e-commerce is that first it is done using computer and digital devices, then it is being carried out on computer network, and it involves processes, one or many processes like buying, selling, transferring, serving, and exchanging. So if you want to have a look at the e-commerce framework, so that framework consists of what kind of applications e-commerce can support, then it can talk about how people are involved in e-commerce framework. Then it also talk about what kind of infrastructural support required for e-commerce, and then it talks about the management. So if you look at the applications are manifold. Like there can be marketing, there can be stocks, there can be online banking, there can be procurement and purchase, then there can be auctions, there can be travel. Publishing is one of the important application which is now again booming up. Then there can be customer servicing and customer so there can be e-government also, there can be e-learning. All these are coming under the applications of e-commerce. So basically all these applications, how these applications of e-commerce are supported, these applications of e-commerce are supported by many people involved. Who are involved in e-commerce? Who are the people who are involved in the e-commerce? There are buyers and there are sellers. However, there will be many other people and management which is supporting this e-commerce framework. These people are using some of the policies when to work e-commerce efficiently somehow, and legally there are many policies which are involved. And what are these policies? Of course, these policies include the kind of taxes, and then legal issues or legal policies, privacy issues. There are regulations from the government, and all that is also included as far as the e-commerce is concerned. One more important aspect of e-commerce is regarding marketing and advertisement. So because most of the e-commerce applications are internet based, there can be a lot of information that can reach to the customer as far as this marketing and advertisement is concerned. And then one more important aspect of e-commerce where the people are involved is called as the supply chain management. There can be a chain of buyers and seller, and the logistic required for all this can very easily supported as far as this e-commerce framework is concerned. Now we have seen that what kind of applications are supported in e-commerce. Then we have discussed about how they are being supported. The next important aspect is about, in order to support this e-commerce application, we require infrastructure. And what kind of infrastructure is required? Basically, definitely the infrastructure include the basic business services infrastructure required. Whether it is a traditional business or whether e-commerce business, some basic infrastructure is required. That may include the smart cards or authentication or kind of thing. So that is what is the basic infrastructure required for e-commerce. The second kind of infrastructure required is the messaging and information distribution, which include the emails and hypertext transfer protocol and chats and all that. As we know, today is the world of advertisement, and then for that, the e-commerce is ready, and it is that all aspects of advertisement are supported by multimedia and content and network publishing infrastructure. Then definitely, if this has to be supported over internet, we require a network, and then we network infrastructure, which include, for example, which include the telecom infrastructure, then it may require WAN or LAN. And lastly, the databases and logistic infrastructure is also required in order to support the e-commerce application. And of course, in order to organize this in a proper way, what we require is the management. So basically, e-commerce framework consists of the type of application, the kind of people support required, and the kind of infrastructure required to support these applications. So we were talking about e-commerce, and one more term which is being used is today is called as the e-business. Now, what is an e-business, or how e-business differs from e-commerce? Basically, e-business refers to a broader context of e-commerce. It extends the scope of e-commerce by including some more aspect or some more application, like serving customer, collaborating with the business partner, conducting e-learning, conducting electronic transaction within the same organization. All this may be a part of the e-commerce. This may be a part of e-business. So please pause this video over here for some time and differentiate between e-commerce and e-business. And please give an example of e-commerce as well as give an example of e-business. I think you are ready with the answer, and now you can differentiate between e-commerce and e-business and can give examples of e-commerce as well as e-business also. Coming back to e-commerce, there are different types of e-commerce involved. Some of the popular types of the e-commerce include B2B, that is business to business, B2C, business to consumer, C2C, consumer to consumer, B2B2C, that is business to business to consumer, C2B, consumer to business, there then can be some intra-business commerce, and lastly, there can be government to citizens, which is called as the G2C model. Let us explore some of the models in today's session. One of the most popular applications of e-commerce is business to business, and it composes the majority of the e-commerce volume. If we look at the total e-commerce volume, the majority of this volume comes not from business to customer, which we may think of, but the majority of the volume comes from business to business. And what is a business to business application? Two business organizations are doing electronic commerce amongst them is called as the business to business application. And it covers all activity along the supply chain management. There are three major models of business to business application. The first one is a sell side marketplace. Then there is a buy side marketplace, and there is a public or electronic exchange. So let us understand what are these. What is a sell side marketplace? What is a buy side marketplace? And what is a public exchange, public or electronic exchange? In case of sell side marketplace, organization sell product to other organization electronically. So they declare that these are our product available electronically, and then those who are interested can buy those product again electronically. In case of buy side marketplace, the buyer organization puts the need, and then the sellers, one or more seller, can submit the bid, and then the business can go ahead. In case of electronic exchange, there will be multiple buyers and multiple sellers coming together on a single platform, and then they can sell and buy. Business to business application also include collaborative commerce, which is non-buying or selling activity, but it can include some of the activity like planning and scheduling. Then it can include the design of the product. Then the new product information is being disseminated. That will also take place under the business to business application. Product content management, order management, and sourcing and procurement, all this can be a part of what is called as the business to business applications. The second type of popular application is called as the business to consumer application. And there are two sub-models or types of business to consumer application. The first is called as an electronic storefront, where the electronic retailing extension of the physical store, and which is frequently used directly by the manufacturer. So along with their normal mode of operation, they have what is called as an electronic storefront, and that is one of the application of business to consumer. And the second application or second type is called as an electronic mall or cyber mall, where collection of many e-storefront under one internet address on one single platform is available, then it is called as an electronic mall. As far as this electronic storefront is concerned, I think that the most popular, one of the popular example I can quote is about the Domino's Pizza, where the manufacturer is directly having an electronic storefront. Either I can walk into the actual physical shop and can buy me a pizza, or I can, there can be an electronic interface or electronic storefront where I can select my pizza and I can order for that. And this is an example, this is an excellent example of Domino's Pizza or a similar kind of application, maybe an example of electronic storefront. As far as this electronic mall is concerned, yes, no need to tell about that. The websites like the Flipkart and Amazon are electronic mall where you can buy multiple of product, and then in for every product there will be multiple options available to you, so you can log in and can do the shopping. So in today's, with that, we come to the end of the second session on electronic commerce. The references used for this are Information Technology for Management by Turbin and Volvino and Information System by Ralph Steer. Thank you, dear student, for patient listening.